Experts all over are trying to understand the complex nature of this novel coronavirus. It is a tough task to decode, but it seems like there are ways that scientists are trying out to better understand this pathogen. We have with us, joining us today, Massachusetts Institute of Technology scientist Marcus Bueller to tell us a little more. His analogy is quite interesting. He compares coronavirus with classical music. He's even composed classical music to describe better the pattern of this deadly virus. Marcus joining us. Marcus, thank you very much for speaking to us.
Thanks for having
me
today.
Very interesting analogy, Marcus. If you could explain to us, you know, India is a hub for classical music, and you've gone on to compose a set which describes this pathogen, the pattern of it.
Yeah, so when we think about proteins, which are really the building blocks of all life on this planet, proteins are made from what we call amino acids, which are little particles encoded by DNA. And if we look at these microscopic, nanoscopic chemical structures, we realize that they're continuously vibrating at certain frequencies. And what we've done in the work, we have calculated these frequencies, these vibrations, and made them audible, and use these audible frequencies to translate the sequence and the structure of these proteins in the coronavirus into musical expression. And what's resulting of that actually is quite complex, a piece of classical music which runs for about an hour, 50 minutes, that encodes the entire three-dimensional hierarchical structure of the spike protein in the virus.
Who are you working with? Is there, are there researchers who are studying your report as well? And you did mention about how for the eyes, you need that much visual to make to understand what a virus can do. But for the ear, it's so quick to grasp.
Right. Yeah, it's quite interesting. When we think about sound and music, our brains have actually evolved over, you know, millions of years, billions of years in human evolution to be very effective in absorbing information with great detail. And if you think about our eyes, if you think about a microscope or a picture, you need many different photos and pictures and text to really understand what's going on in the geometric physical world. With our ears, we're able to basically listen to sound and pick up all the details through many different scales of information.
Initial part of the music is quite soothing and beautiful, as listeners describe it, and as it transcends, it gets complicated, and that's how the virus acts on a human body. It starts off very humbly into the human body.
You know, the virus basically tricks the human human cells by pretending to be a friendly visitor. Uses a lock and key mechanism to gain entry to the cells, and then basically the cells help.
It starts off as a common flu, and then develops into a fever, and then your whole paralyzes your respiratory system, your organs eventually.
Right. Yeah, so the music is an analogy to this, and I think it's a way for not only for the science in developing new proteins and ways of mitigating the threat through mechanical vibrations, but also it's a way for us to engage the general public in thinking about proteins. The proteins really are the building blocks of all life. They are the building blocks that are the brick and mortar, the concrete material that is used to actually build the virus.
You've got many listeners to it already on SoundCloud. You've released it there.
And I think it's really very encouraging to see how many people are engaging with this music and inspired by it and maybe working with it. I've seen a lot of requests. People are trying to work with the composition, performing the composition. We even had a player, and you can find it on Twitter, in Turkey, who actually used his bassoon and played along with the music and published that on Twitter.
Music composition of yours could help researchers find antibody with the help of artificial intelligence. Please explain.
Yes. Yeah, so when you think about proteins, the proteins are really are encoded by DNA. You know, everybody knows about DNA, of course, but DNA aren't actually what makes a body really work. They are just the building block for proteins that actually are the kind of the machinery of our body, the cells, the organs, and the virus. And so what the big question is in the science community is really how do we understand the language that DNA speaks to define, to design proteins that appear, like I said, in living systems, in pathologies like in viruses. And when we have a way of translating the protein structure into music, we can begin to learn that language. So you can imagine listening to the protein in this virus and beginning to understand how it functions, how it works. Now, the human brain can do that, and we can think about creating antibodies that would bind very well to the spike protein to prevent further infections. But another way of doing that is using artificial intelligence. AI is this is a really powerful tool of teaching an artificial neural network, an artificial brain, if you wish, to speak that language of proteins and do all sorts of things with that.
We hope that researchers do take an interest into your study, maybe get a step closer to finding an antibody. Thank you very much. All the best to you, Marcus.
Hello everyone, this is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.